Hello guys, good morning and welcome to the channel Final Whistle, the channel that brings you the best and the best of every sporting analysis, fans' reaction, pre and post match analysis, and of course match in depth analysis, and of course sport like related stories. And our super Eagles boys are still stranded.
Good morning, bro.
Are you sure it's a good morning?
Yeah. So it's a good morning first of all, because we have to start well first. And I won't lie to you, I'm here to give you updates, situation report, over 13 hours now, and our boys are still stranded. Ogochukwu and Ewa, you guys are the men of the
house. We've not slept since yesterday night, bro.
I'm telling you, you know, yesterday we told them we are not going to sleep. I followed this whole event from
so disheartening
that nobody expected to go this. At some point, I felt like, okay, they're going to come to a compromise. But no, these guys are still bent on doing what they want to do. They are still at the airport over 13 hours since landing without food and water. Is this, let's not forget about football. Humanity, for humanity's sake, for God's sake. Is this proper? Is this proper? You keep humans without a place to sleep or stretch their legs over 13 hours.
It's looking like a pre-planned something.
Obviously, it's a pre-planned something. You can't tell me this thing now. Yesterday we talked about how they diverted the plane. Mm. That was done. Now the NFF, in their own good distance, look for a way, a measure to, you know, try to find a way around this whole thing. But guess what? No Libyan FA official was in the airport. So who would you talk to? That aside, they made provisions for buses to take the players that night immediately. When the whole thing, for security reasons and everything, to the better destination. Did you know that they refused entrance? The buses were refused entrance into the airport as the airport was locked down by higher authority. So this is not, we are no longer playing with Libya FA football. It is now more like a, I don't want to use the word war, but it feels like enter Kinikon something.
Just a second. The airport staffs got an information or got an order from an higher authority not to open the door. I'm sure you have seen the movie 13 Hours in Benin. Speaking more like
Official Larry Charles, we always saw this coming. Ever since the captain of that team said what he said about the old treatment in Uyo, so I knew that it was going to be serious problem. And we saw this thing play out in 2022 when the Enyimba actually played at Alitiya. After the match venue was changed, they kept the players for hours in the airport. So it's just a similar situation, similar event. And then from all indications, from the reports that we've seen, I think maybe the production manager was putting up some of the posts that we actually saw that they actually tweeted to their people. Like, they already had this thing planned out. Because someone said Nigeria won Libya. He was not referring to the scoreline. Obviously, he was not referring to the scoreline.
Let me quickly read.
He was referring to what they are going to be giving us when we get there. So now the plan is for them to be stuck. Knowing fully well that the match is 8 o'clock tomorrow. Let them be stuck in the airport. When they didn't meet fit to open the gate, now they will now leave them to travel for another three or four hours to Benghazi. Knowing fully well that you have a match 8 o'clock tomorrow.
Now let me even quickly, to protest what you are saying. This is from a Libyan source. You must sleep on the floor. We have technical faults and we will not be able to fix them until the morning. Do not complain. Sleep on the floor. We will be able to solve the problem later in the morning.
Ugochukwu, please. I want to die this.
Now some of the players are getting sick.
That's where I'm coming from now. Hey, why? These players that we have, some of them didn't actually grow in Africa.
Yeah.
They were actually born and bred outside the country in the best conditions. They are playing under the best conditions. Like we say, we have players playing in the top clubs in the top.
Yeah.
Are we expecting them to still give even 50% in that match? Is that match going to even still hold?
No, for sure. In as much as I really don't want us to differentiate between players that grew up in, like, all of them are in this situation.
Yeah.
But I'm just a little bit concerned about the ones that have not even played for us, the likes of Tosin Adarabi Oyo, that will be probably seeing this, having still in the situation of wanting to decide whether to play for the Three Lions or to play for the Super Eagles. You want to probably see yourself in this kind of situation. How do I? You understand? I think he's selling. He shows
the
lot
about more like a hostage situation.
Because Official and Charles, if we, as a continent, we always say, we always lend our voice when the Europeans are treating us bad. We call it racism. And then right there in our own continent, we are treating ourselves like this in Africa.
You know, I've always said that the North African guys are not people to be toyed with. I've always maintained that stand. They are not one that they don't see us as one from the onset. You can't ask our black brothers that move around Africa. In all the regions on the world, I think it is in North Africa that we have less of Nigerians plying their trade there. Now, this is another person's tweet, a Libyan guy. This is what you have done to yourselves. We do not care about qualifying. It is not about the game for them.
It's not about the game.
What is important for us is reciprocal treatment and restoring our rights for your bad treatment to our national team. So this is not about the game. They don't want to qualify.
I think this is nonsense from Libya. This is not something that we will not take. In as much as we have always said CAF should always oversee these things, I think it's not something that we want to see in our football.
For God's sake.
You understand? No, I really don't have confidence in CAF. When we are still talking about the VAR, we are still talking about VAR.
But then this kind of major decision.
It looks as if nothing is happening. Because we are supposed to have taken our football to another level. This is not what, compared to what happened in Uyo, which is as a result of misinformation. This is not misinformation. If you want to win on the pitch, you understand? If you are so good, you don't have to frustrate your opponent, you understand, because of 3 points, because you really want to, you understand? Like that was why we were angry when we saw that 1-0 slim win.
Yes. Yeah.
Because I felt like this is a Libyan side, they are supposed to have just dampened their morale on the pitch. Give them the goals, let them know that going forward, there's nothing to expect. You understand?
AY and Oguchukwu, this has happened now.
Yeah.
You understand now? What is the possible solution
now? Let me
be frank now. We saw this coming. Final Whistle as a team,
yeah,
as a production unit, we have actually speculated that this might happen or even worse.
Mm.
We saw it coming. We gave our viewers a production on this, and yes, we said the NFF should actually make measures
and they did
to prevent this, and they did, because they actually saw it coming. Because you know, Africans, you know, we to an extent we are petty. So what is the way forward now? Because the boys are still stranded.
If these boys are going to play this football, I think it's on them.
Yes.
Yeah, and if they do not agree to play, it is justifiable.
Yes, justifiable.
It is justifiable.
I'm thinking of the same.
You cannot expect the game is today is Monday.
Yes.
You cannot, and the game is tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
We've not rested. We've not been properly fed.
They don't know the terrain.
They don't know the terrain. They still have 3 hours
training.
As it stands now, some players are currently sick.
Yeah.
To some extent that the Nigeria government had to send security yesterday because the players were.
It's looking like more of a security issue.
It was a security issue.
Yeah, it's looking like more of a security.
You keep someone in
the airport. You don't keep somebody
over 13 hours. That's hostage.
Yeah.
It's no longer delay flights.
This
is lockdown. Because they made provisions for bosses to come and take these players. You refuse them. So it is hostage. That is the word to be used.
Yeah.
And by UN, this is, in fact, I don't want to mention the word, but that's what it is.
Security threat, yeah.
Yes, I agree with
that.
That
is what it is. But I don't want to blame them. I want to blame ourselves for the fact that some of these countries have the guts to deal with us in this way. It shows that they are seeing us in one view.
I think it's the audacity and for them coming out on media space to actually even say, yes, this is it.
They will do it. And then there's
personally, I think the FA should be sanctioned. Even the captain, anyway, he didn't even get career. I don't understand a country, Libya, with over six million people compared to Nigeria with over.
They can't enter Lagos, we will beat them.
Save up Lagos.
I'm an opa.
No, this is a shameful one. But regardless, this is Final Whistle giving you fresh update all the way from Libya as our players are still stranded 13 to 14 hours from now. And this is a painful one, I won't lie to you, because football is supposed to be a thing of joy, a thing of sportsmanship, and this is not happening, not in Africa again. We thought we have actually gone far from this thing. But regardless, keep time with Final Whistle as well, your short plug to bring you happenings concerning this issue, because this issue is not yet done. It's not yet done. Thank you.